I was looking for a good quality multimeter from a reputable brand. It had to be safe and easy to use in every situational encounter, while still being relatively cheap. First option was EEVBlog branded BM235. To save some money, I decided to look at the Brymen branded version instead. Then I found out a way to save another 20 euros. This Brymen BM231 is very similar to BM235. We can straight away see that one button and couple of measuring modes are missing from this model, none of which are essential for me, and I didn't want to pay any extra for those non-essential features. In addition to better build quality and safety, this multimeter also has some cool features that most cheap multimeters don't have. Instead of full review, I will show you a couple of these features. First feature that I like is continuity mode. In some situations one may not always hear the beep, but check this out. This multimeter also has a visual indicator, blinking backlight, which can be easily seen even when not looking directly at the display. You saw how I had to press select to go from resistance mode to continuity mode. Nothing special there. But here's the cool part. This multimeter has a memory which remembers the last used mode on each selector switch position. So in this selector switch position, the continuity mode is active after power on instead of resistance mode. And it of course works with other modes as well. For example, when measuring volts, at first it is in DC mode. But if I select AC, VFD mode and switch power off and on again, the mode is still AC-VFD. This is a handy feature which makes this multimeter adapt to measuring habits of the user. I can see how this can be annoying, but for me this is a huge plus. I mentioned this being quite similar to BM235. The box has list of features and we can see what is missing from this multimeter. First one is mode which can automatically measure DC or AC volts based on which has higher peak value. It also has low initial impedance which gets rid of so-called ghost voltages. I personally don't need that feature almost at all, but for many users that could be a more important feature. Then there are capacitance and frequency modes, still nothing I'd pay extra to get. Temperature reading is handy, but not necessary for me. I use these features very rarely, so I don't need to have them in my main, everyday multimeter. This BM231 has most of nice features of BM235. 6000 count display with 5 times per second update rate. Intelligent auto power off, which monitors for user activity, not just the button presses. This can record max min readings and calculate average. And beep when max or min value has changed. Visual continuity indicator, which I demonstrated quickly, then some quite basic features. Another special one is beep that warns if user forgets probe in the current input jacks while having the selector switch in some other mode. Let's demonstrate that. You are measuring current and after that you decide to measure volts, but forget to move the probe to correct jack. Multimeter tells you about input error by beeping and showing a text on the display. You most likely won't miss that. You may wonder why this doesn't happen when the multimeter is in current mode, but the probe is not in the current input jack. Well, that isn't as dangerous thing. You'll just get a zero reading, but if you have a probe in current input jack and try to measure volts, the multimeter will make a short circuit and you will blow a fuse inside the meter. The fuse is there to prevent bigger damage from happening, but one blown fuse is one blown fuse more than I like. That's why I really like this warning feature. I think this multimeter is well worth the price, which is around 20 euros lower than the BM235. At least for those living in Europe, I can recommend brymen.eu, great prices and quick shipment. It's free to subscribe to my channel and to like this video. It would mean a lot if you could do those things. Thanks. Bye.